Am I ready for a new relationship? If you have ever asked yourself this question, then this video is specifically for you. In this video, I will share with you the checklist that indicates you are ready for a new relationship. This list includes 5 signs, and please remember that if you only possess 1 sign or 2 or 3 signs or even 4 signs out of these 5 signs, it doesn't mean that you're ready for a new relationship. You want to obtain all of these 5 signs to be mentally and emotionally ready to build a strong and happy relationship with your new partner. With that awareness in mind, now let's check out what are the 5 signs that determine you are ready for a new relationship. The first sign is you have completely moved on from your past relationship and your previous partner. Moving on from the past is the first and super crucial step before you start a new relationship. Do you still have any strong feelings when you hear your ex name? The feelings are not necessary about missing and wanting to go back. Feelings here could be resentment, anger, hurt, or sadness. If you still experience any of these feelings, I highly suggest spending more time to recover your heart and your soul from the past relationship before involving with someone romantically. If you're with a new partner but still emotionally attached to your ex, you are ruining your new relationship and do a disservice to yourself and your new partner. I will make a future video where I will be sharing how to heal your heart and move on from the past relationship. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and turn the bell notification on to have YouTube alert you when that video is out. Now, if you're totally fine and firm hearing your ex name and you don't feel hurt knowing they just get into a new relationship with someone else, then you're indeed have moved on from the past. You're now a step closer to build a relationship with a new partner. The next sign is you have reflected and learned from the past. Moving on from an ex is not enough for you to start another chapter of your life with a new partner yet. You also need to reflect and learn from your past relationship. Reflect and learn from your previous relationship means looking back and realizing what you did right and what you could have done better. Reflect also means to find the answer why your past relationship came to an end. Even though it may seem like it's all your ex's fault, you were still a part of that relationship, and therefore, you were responsible for the ending of that relationship too. Regardless your ex was a narcissistic, abusive, or cheating on you, ask yourself questions such as, what were the lessons you learned from that relationship and what you could have done better? It doesn't matter how bad your ex was to you, you need to be accountable for the relationship and its ending since it was your choice to be with your ex in the first place. Without reflecting and learning from your past relationship, you will make the same past mistakes in your new relationship. If you get into a new relationship without learning and improving yourself, your new relationship will later end with the same reason as your past relationship ended, and your new partner will be soon or later another ex. The third sign is you completely fine being single. I know this may sound contradictory at first, but hear me out and you will soon understand why it makes its way to the list. Being happily single means you are comfortable with your own skin, that you don't feel left out if you go to an event full of couples, that you feel good about yourself being single despite your friends or your family members pressure you to have a boyfriend or a girlfriend. You don't feel that you're incomplete or less desirable. You don't feel like you must be someone to be more worthy. You don't jump to a relationship for validation, attention, or to please anyone. Instead, you get into a relationship when you meet someone who matches your personalities and your values, someone who is compatible with you and your lifestyle. And most importantly, you're in a relationship with someone because both of you want to. With this mentality, you will build a great future relationship when you meet a partner that matches what you're looking for. When you don't rush the process of finding someone to be your partner, you actually become more attractive. The attractiveness comes from your confidence. You're confident because you don't find a partner to please your parents or anyone. A confident person is someone who does things that he or she likes and believes in, rather for others' opinions. You certainly don't get into a relationship for a status update or the likes on your social media account. The interesting thing about life is that when you have this confidence in yourself, you unconsciously attract so many great things in life, which includes your future great partner. The next vital sign is that you're willing to take risk. As much certain as you claim about your new partner and how great he or she is, getting into a relationship with someone is a risk. In fact, everything in life is risky. It is never a 100% guarantee that you're going to have a perfect and lasting relationship with your partner. This is not because that person may do something behind your back or something happens that takes their life away. These are extreme cases, but it could happen. What I'm referring to here is the change in you and your partner. Your partner and you will grow and change as time goes by. Change is inevitable. You may change your lifestyle, your values, your hobbies, or your interests, and the same applies to your partner too. Some couples grow together, yet some grow apart. Look at your relationships with your besties during high school or university. Chances are, some of your friends are no longer close to you as they used to be. When you have the awareness that nothing is certain but change, you know that getting into a relationship is a risk. Yet, the beauty of it is you will appreciate and enjoy every single moment with your future partner, that you will not take him or her for granted. And as a result, your relationship may actually turn out to be thriving and lasting. The last sign in the list is you're ready to learn and expand your heart. As much compatible as you think you are with your new partner, he or she is a separate human being with certain beliefs and views that differ from yours. The way they look at love, relationship, support, or companionship may be slightly different from yours. Therefore, the way your partner wants to be loved may be not the same as how you want to be loved. As a result, you need to learn to communicate your needs effectively to your partner and also actively listen to their needs if you want to build a great long-term relationship. You need to open your heart and learn your partner's love language. With the mindset of constant learning and growing, your relationship is going to thrive and continue getting better and better. These are the five signs that determine you are ready for a new great relationship. Let me know in the comment below how many signs that you possess and what are the signs that you need to work on. Don't forget to also comment down below any questions related to relationship or dating that you want me to answer in my future videos. Thank you for your attention. If you like the video, then don't forget to give it a like and also share it with someone that could benefit from it. I hope you have a great day. Take care and I will see you in my next video. Bye bye!